did. I was working 3 jobs now, true story. I'm working 9 to 5. I'm working in the evening, 6 to 10. I'm now also working in the weekends. So now I'm spending no time with the family, no time with the kids. And I'm still broke. Real talk. You know how it is. Mortgage, council tax, gas, electric, you know, kids sending them to school. It was hard. It was really, really financially difficult. So I went home again. I said, babes, I got it. I said, I'm going to get another job. I'm going to get a job working in my lunch break. My mother worked hard, father went around, grandparents worked hard. You know, I watched my family work hard for everything they got. So that was my attitude, just like this hammer, that if you want things in life, you've got to work hard for them. And I worked harder and harder and harder and harder and harder. I mean, I was working so hard, it almost brought me to breaking point. And you know the sad thing about the story is, ladies? Einstein said it best. Einstein said talent is distributed evenly. Einstein said it best. Talent is distributed evenly. Now all this time that I was working with my hammer, I never once stopped in over 25 years. I'm 38, so from 15 to 38, true story. I never once stopped to take a look in my toolbox and see what tools that I could have in there that could help work for me. I was working with my hammer and I never stopped to look in my toolbox to see what tools have I got in my box that can aid me. We're all blessed, guys. We're all blessed with a gift. We're all blessed with a talent. We're all blessed with something. God created everybody perfectly imperfect. We're not the same, but we've all got something. Some people live their whole lives and they never discover their true calling. If you're anything like me, I was too busy working, thinking about the bills, thinking about the kids, thinking about all the responsibilities I had, to actually stop and look at myself and see, what are my gifts, what are my talents, what are my skills? So I want to tell you another story. A farmer, and this farmer, he had an eagle's egg, and this farmer placed the eagle's egg in a nest with chicken eggs. This eagle hatched amongst chickens. This eagle naturally thought he was a chicken, and he done everything chickens do. If you've seen chickens, their claws like that, they scratch around in the dirt, the worms. Chickens do for worms. But that's what this eagle was doing. This eagle was scratching around in the dirt for worms. And this eagle was pecking around in the dirt for worms. But the sad thing about this story is, every single day of this eagle's life, this eagle would look up in the sky and look at all the other eagles soaring in the sky. And this eagle wished he too could soar in the sky like all the other eagles. But because this eagle was placed in a nest with chicken eggs and he hatched amongst chickens, nobody ever told this eagle that he was an eagle. He thought he was a chicken. Now, unfortunately, that can happen to the best of us at times. We can be in environments that are not conducive to success. The friends that we're around, the circles, the company we keep, it's not conducive to success. And sometimes we can be doing some chicken stuff. Now, before any animal rights activists get to me, I love chicken, by the way. Stew, I love fried chicken. I love porridge chicken. I'm a lot of jerk chicken. But I'm not a chicken. But what do we do? We're in that situation when we've got no one to validate our self-worth. The company that we're keeping, no one in that circle is going to tell us, you're not a chicken, you shouldn't be doing that. When you've got no parents, no mother, no father, no loved ones, no cousins, no aunties, no uncles, no good company around you to validate your self-worth. Because a lot of times, we judge ourselves based on society's standards of us. We judge ourselves by what other people think of us, what other people say about us. We limit ourselves and we restrict ourselves based on what other people tell us we can and cannot do. You can't do that. You're not educated enough. You can't do that. You're too old. You can't do that. You ain't got enough money. We limit and restrict ourselves based on what everybody else has told us, everyone else's opinions of us, everyone else's views on us, their limits, their restrictions. What do we do in that situation when there's no one around to tell us or validate our self-worth, ladies and gentlemen? Somebody help me. What do we do? And how do you do that? You've got to look in the mirror. You've got to look in the mirror. You've got to look at the reflection of yourself. You've got to ask yourself an honest question. Forget what everyone else thinks of you. You've got to look in your mirror, the mirror. You've got to ask yourself, is the reflection that I'm looking at, am I looking at a chicken? Or am I looking at an eagle? If you're looking at a chicken, then you carry on doing chicken stuff. If your answer is an eagle, like I said, ladies and gentlemen, Einstein said it best. Einstein said talent is distributed evenly. And I don't know anybody in this room, but I know something about every single body in this room. I'll say it again. I don't know anybody in this room, but I know something about every single body in this room. None of you were born chickens. You're all born eagles. So what I want you to do, ladies and gentlemen, I want you to spread your wings. Yeah, start flying like an eagle. Yeah. And be all you can be. Yeah. I'm going to break down a couple of attributes of the eagle. The difference between an eagle and a chicken is this. Chickens suffer from possibility blindness. I'll say it again. Chickens suffer from possibility blindness. A chicken will tell you why you can't do that. A chicken's going to tell you why you're too old to do that. A chicken's going to dampen your dreams and put doubt in your mind and tell you why you should stay in your current 9-to-5 job. Don't get me wrong, I'm not knocking the 9-to-5 worker. But what I'm saying to you is that if you've got a dream, if you've got a goal, if you've got an ambition, if you've got an idea, yeah, or a talent, a skill, something inside you that you want to chase, that you want to unlock, that you want to go for, do not let possibility, doubt, fear, or any of the above get in the way. And I don't like to just come up and say, woohoo, yeah, positive PMA. I'm living proof, ladies and gentlemen. For those that do know me, they will tell you, like I said, for the last 38 years, I've been working three jobs. And I'm a person, talk about myself. I've been working three jobs. And December, just gone. After 38 years of breaking my back, working hard, not getting anywhere, and still being broke, I've had loads of jobs. I stopped and I looked at my toolbox for the first time in 38 years. And I was surprised, ladies and gentlemen. I was surprised when I sat down by myself and said to myself, what am I good at? What are my skills? What are my gifts? What are my talents? And this is when I came to the conclusion. Just before Christmas, it dawned on me. From when I was a child, my grandmother always said, you should be a politician. In my line of work, people indirectly call me Mr. Motivator because I'm always motivating them without realizing it. And I looked at myself and I realized that I'm blessed with the gift of speech. I never knew it before, my whole life. At school, I used to get in trouble for being talkative all the time. And after coming to the realization that God blessed me with the gift of speech. I hit the ground running and I never looked back. I entered the World Motivational Speaker Competition. I'm not a professional speaker. I've never done this before. And I won. Oh, yeah. So humbly, not only am I giving you encouragement and I hope to inspire you and give you strength, but I'm not just saying, you know, don't be a chicken, be an eagle. I'm living proof of what happens when you spread your wings and start flying like an eagle. And when you find your true calling and you just go through it, things will shift and work in your favor in a way that is unbelievable. So ladies and gentlemen, the story about the eagle and the chicken is an analogy that I believe everybody can relate to in some respect. You know, it might be a promotion that you wanted to go for but always thought you weren't good enough for. Be an eagle. Go for that promotion. You know, it might be a business idea that you always wanted to start but put it off till next year when the kids are a bit older. You know, when I've got a bit more money, do it now. You know, I've got a saying that I live by. Do what you can, where you can, with what you've got. And that's what I started doing from in December when I realized that I'm a gifted speaker. And my life has changed. So, how long have I got? Some time while I'm there? Huh? Hello?
No time. As long as you want.
As long as I want. God bless you. I'll step in for another hour.
It's got talking on.
Thank you, Ace. Eagles and chickens. So yeah, I'm just going to give you some attributes of an eagle quickly, ladies and gentlemen. But this is important, because what will happen is, when you've got no one around you to validate your self-worth, and you look in the mirror and you start validating yourself and becoming confident in yourself, there will be people that will come around you and put doubt on you. There will be people that will put you down. And when you find your true calling, not everyone's going to be happy. People, when God starts blessing you, people get mad. So I'm going to give you some attributes of an eagle, just to leave you with. Eagles don't fly in flocks, okay? So if you're waiting for your friends to join you on your journey, you'll be waiting a long time. You stay with the chickens, because chickens huddle together. Yeah, eagles don't fly in flocks. Eagles aren't an eagle. Is there any eagles in the room? Oh, I'm to death, that's what I like to say. If you're an eagle, make someone say to me, I'm an eagle.
All right.
Is there any chickens in the room? Okay, but we like to eat chicken, yeah? So I'm gonna leave you a couple of attributes of an eagle, and then I'm gonna chip out. So firstly, eagles don't fly in flocks, yeah? And I love this one. Eagles fly at an altitude that is so high, the only other bird an eagle sees at the altitude he flies at is another eagle. I'll say it again. Eagles fly at an altitude that is so high, the only thing they see at the altitude they fly is another eagle. Eagles, they don't eat nothing that's dead. Eagles don't scavenge. Vultures eat dead food. Eagles only eat fresh food. Think about it, you are what you eat. Are you serving the 1 minute sign? Alright, cool. Like, so, this is my favorite part about eagles. Because Ace has had a hard life. I've been so hard, I had to be comfortable being uncomfortable. That's one of my mantras. Uncomfortable being uncomfortable. So let me tell you the last thing about eagle before I go. Eagles love the storm. I'll say it again. Do you know what an eagle loves when a storm comes out? The eagles, they spread their wings and they use the tailwinds of the storm to glide. So they're saving energy. Eagles welcome the storm. They glide in the storm. While all the other birds, they're hiding in the trees. Hey, Scott talk. Yeah. Thank you very much. I've got a 30-second sign coming up, guys.